हेलो स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ मिनल पवार फ्रॉम HGM कॉलेज कराड. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स 10th नंबर टॉपिक मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ड्यू टू द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ऑफ सॉलिनॉइड. लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव टू लर्न हियर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ड्यू टू द लॉन्ग स्ट्रेट कंडक्टर. एंड लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव टू लर्न द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ एम्पियर्स लॉ ऑल्सो. That Ampere's law is line integrals of vector B dot vector dl is equal to their mu zero I here. This last lecture we have learned. Now is what is the statement of Ampere's law? Ampere's law that line integrals of magnetic field of induction along any closed path in free space is equal to absolute permeability of medium in free space. Their mu zero time total current flowing through the area which is bounded by the any closed path. Now last lecture we learned that is magnetic field into dl is equal to mu zero I. Now in this lecture we are going to learn magnetic field of solenoid. Here this diagram is solenoid diagram is here drawn. Here also we can draw the schematic diagram of solenoid here. The schematic diagram of solenoid. Here schematic diagram of solenoid we are going to draw here. Now see here, that is this is the one type of the solenoid. Solenoid is long, there is closely wound the coils of conducting wires. That we assume that the diameter of the wire is much smaller than the length of the wire. That is the schematic diagram of solenoid. That one more diagram is we drawn here. Here is uniform magnetic field in between the solenoid. Here also this sign indicate current into the out of the paper and this sign indicate current into the plane of the paper. Now here is the rectangular loop ABCD. Here is here that is the Amperean loops. This rectangular loop is one type of the Amperean loop. Last lecture we seen Amperean loop means that imaginary circle or imaginary line drawn around the any shape of the conductors. Now see here, this is the schematic diagram of the solenoid. Here the density of magnetic field lines, density of magnetic field line along the axis of the solenoid is at the larger distance which is away from the length of wire. So this wire is uniform here. Wire is uniform here. Here also one more is diagram. This both of the diagram showing the that is solenoids. Solenoids of here and there is solenoid is placed in there. Solenoid is in inside the solenoid. There is magnetic field is more here. Inside the solenoid there is magnetic field is there is more here. Now see here there is magnetic field is parallel to the axis of the solenoid. This magnetic field produced inside the solenoid is parallel to the axis of the solenoid. Here also see the magnetic field is parallel to the axis of solenoid. Both the diagram magnetic field is parallel to the axis of the solenoid here. Now see here that the magnetic field lines is widely spaced or weak the outside the solenoid. In this diagram A and here diagram B, this diagram inside this diagram it is the real infinite solenoid. The real solenoid it consists of infinite solenoid or the magnetic field is uniform and good strength at the center of the solenoid and outside the solenoid magnetic field is weak here. Outside the solenoid magnetic field is weak here. Now for there is consider the axis of the solenoid. Therefore we applying Ampere's law. Now last year lecture that we that prove the Ampere's law. Line integration of vector B dot vector dl is equal to mu 0 r. This is the Ampere's law. Now here the Amperean loops drawn around this here solenoid. The rectangular loop ABCD. The rectangular loop ABCD. How to apply the Ampere law here for rectangular loop ABCD? We have to apply Ampere's law here. Now see here, for loop ABCDA, for applying Ampere's law. Applying Ampere's law. Now see the line integral of the line integrals of vector. Here see this side A to B vector B dot dl plus line integrals of B to C vector B dot dl plus line integral of C to D vector B dot dl plus line integrals of vector D to A vector B dot dl is equal to mu 0 r here. For applying the Ampere's law, the rectangular loop ABCDA, rectangular loop ABCDA here. Now first see which terms here became 0 and which terms is remained whole in here. Now see here, first term is became here B dot L, second term became 0, third term become 0 and fourth term also became 0. BL is equal to mu 0 I here. BL is equal to mu 0 I here. Now see the first term is BL because the side AB is inside the solenoid. Inside the solenoid here is magnetic field is present. And these two sides, side BC and side DA, which are perpendicular to the magnetic field. So now we have to know the line integrals of vector BDL is equal to BDL cos theta. If perpendicular theta is equal to 90 degree, so this equation became 0. So both the second term and fourth term became 0 because that these two sides are perpendicular to the that magnetic field. And third one is CD, which is the outside the solenoid. Outside the solenoid there is magnetic field is weak or 0. So this term became 0. Now we get equation BL is equal to mu 0 r. This one second equation. Now see here, for applying the here Ampere's law loop, rectangular loop A, B, C, D. The here is, here L be the, here we get last equation. Now we get the equations here. Once again I will write here, BL is equal to mu 0 I. This equation we get now. There is n be the number of the turns of the rectangular coil. Number of the turns of the rectangular coil. Number of the turns per unit length. I be the current flowing through this rectangular coil. Small I be the current flowing through. This small I is equal to current flowing through the rectangular coil. Current flowing through the rectangular coil. So that mu 0 I is equal to mu 0 n l r. This equation we can write mu 0 n l I. This equation we can write mu 0 n l I. Now here substitute the value of mu 0 I in equation second, we get b dot l is equal to mu 0 n l I. That LL cancel, then B is equal to mu 0 N R. That this equation represent magnetic field due to the solenoid. That magnetic field, obtain an expression for magnetic field due to the solenoid. We get B is equal to mu 0 N I. B is magnetic field, here N is the number of the turns here. Now we get this equation. Now Next term is magnetic field of toroid. Magnetic field of toroid. Magnetic field of toroid here. See here. Parent loop is drawn here. Hence, it will be doing here is into the paper and gonna print into them out of here. B is here. Now there is the diagram of toroid here. The toroid is the one type of the solenoid which bent into the that circular tube like structure. That for example here that tires where we are using tire, the rubber tube inside the tire, the pressurized rubber tube inside the tires. That is the example of this toroid here. We drawn here toroid here. Here is ampere loop also we drawn here. Now see here, there the cross section of toroid. Here is drawn here the cross section of toroid as shown in here. Therefore, by applying here Ampere's law. Here also we can apply Ampere's law due to the symmetry. Here is applying the Ampere's law due to the symmetry. We can calculate the magnetic field along the axis of tube. Here is tube is. Tube is inside. The tube-like structure is here. That is one type of the solenoid, but there is tube-like structure inside here. So that is the construction of the solenoid. This is the magnetic field. Here also we can calculate the magnetic field along the central axis of their tube-like structure. Now here also we construct the ampere loops these along the axis of tube. Here also we can use here only tube. So the ampere loop also drawn along the axis of the tube here. The magnetic field lines are here. Magnetic field lines are concentric. Concentric means like this now, circular here. Concentric circular here is made. The magnetic field lines is concentric here. Now here is we applying the magnetic. Here we applying the Ampere's law. Now in this case, the direction of field is indicated by the direction of current flowing. That field direction is indicated the direction of current flowing through this tube-like structure coil. That is toroid. Now here also we can apply Ampere's law. By Ampere's law. Now see here, line integral of vector B dot vector dl is equal to therefore mu 0 r. The line integral of vector B dot vector dl is equal to mu 0 I. Here is I is net current flowing around that encircled. That encircled means that ampere loop is drawn around here. Now here is the dl is the we can write 2 pi r. Then vector B dot 2 pi r is equal to mu 0 r here. This equation we can write. Here also n number of the turn is here. So instead of I we can write B dot 2 pi r is equal to mu 0 n I small I here. I be the current flowing through this toroid here. Now we get B is equal to mu 0, here is capital N is here, not small n, capital N, N I upon 2 pi r. This equation represents magnetic field due to the axis of the toroid. Magnetic field due to the axis of the toroid. Here, magnetic field is inversely proportional to the R. That unlike the solenoid, magnetic field is not constant over the cross section of toroid. Unlike the solenoid, magnetic field is not constant. Its magnetic field is not constant. Unlike the solenoid, here is magnetic field is not constant over the axis of toroid. Now, yes, here. Now, just we will revise the whatever we learn in this throughout section. Now, first of, we will learn here. Last we learned here magnetic force is equal to Fm is equal to I QVB. Magnetic force Fm is equal to QVB sin theta N. Yeah. Last second point we had learned in this topic, cyclotron motion we learned QBR is equal to P is equal to MV. Third one, that FC, frequency of cyclotron, FV is equal to QB upon 2 pi M, and same point is here, kinetic energy is equal to 1 half Q square B square R square Hz upon M. Here, fourth one is magnetic force due to wire, Fm is equal to I L vector L cross vector B. Fifth one is magnetic force due to the arbitrary shaped wire, Fm is equal to I, the integration of vector dl cross vector b. Sixth one is magnetic force due to the closed loop circuit, Fm is equal to 0. Seventh one is torque acting on current loop, NIAB sin theta, NIAB sin theta. And eighth term is here, next term is in moving coil galvanometer, phi is equal to NAB upon K into I. That next one is that by Savart's law, dB is equal to mu 0 I dl sin theta upon 4 pi r square. Now, magnetic field due to the infinite long wire, B is equal to mu 0 I upon 2 pi r. Magnetic field due to the semi-infinite wire, vector B is equal to mu 0 I upon 4 pi r. Now, magnetic field due to the axial loop of the wire, magnetic field due to the axial loop of the wire. Magnetic field due to the axial loop of the wire along the z-axis. BZ is equal to mu zero I R square in bracket Z square plus R square 3/2, and next terms, last terms is Ampere's law, line integration of vector B dot dl is equal to mu zero I. This Ampere's law, and last and least we learn here applications of Ampere's law. That applications of Ampere law here, that magnetic field due to the long straight conductor, magnetic field due to the long straight conductor, magnetic field due to the solenoid, and magnetic field due to the toroid. Now here I hope whatever I taught that you are understand or you are understood. So that is today's, here is that section is last topic, last point is over here. So thank you very much.